All right, so here it is. This is our 2021 Lowrider S that we just picked up from the Harley dealer, and it's got about 75 miles on it. Came to us with about 8, and we've been riding it a little bit, and obviously had to get it back from the dealership, so this is where it sits. Now, the promise I made was that we are gonna make an attempt to do a video for every single thing that we do on this bike, so that you can really see it going from 100% bone stock all the way to a finished product, which we'll talk about a little bit down the road. But to be honest, we've already broken that promise a little bit. We got a little bit of ahead of ourselves, and there's a few things that we already went ahead and did to this bike, and I'll call those out. It's pretty minor, so don't hold it against us. We did go ahead and just right away, we took off the stock foot pegs that come on the bike, and we opted for a set of the pegs from Thrash and Supply. We also put on a matching shifter peg on the other side, as well as a shift linkage from Alloy Art. We'll show you all those things so you can see them. That's all pretty minor stuff. We just started working on that before we kind of had the idea to do a build video series. So don't hold it against us. Like I said, everything else, we'll do our best to do it on video so you can kind of see going from stock to finished. So obviously what you're looking at otherwise is it's a bone stock bike. Before we get into today's project, we'll talk a little bit about this bike. I've said it before, maybe in a video, but certainly to a lot of customers that come in here. Obviously, you know, we're Harley people. I'm a Harley guy. It is what it is. And I've been in love with this bike since day one. The Dyna version is obviously awesome too, but the Milwaukee 8 Softail Lowrider S, in my personal opinion, is really the best all-around bike that Harley is making right now. It's not to start a debate to say that, you know, a Road Glide doesn't have more going on than this does, and it certainly does, and it's got a $10,000 higher price tag that goes along with that. So really, I guess what I want to say is it's the best bang for the buck. It's the best pound for pound, however you want to say it. From the Softail platform, this bike really has all the right stuff. There's a lot of Softails that have some of the components that this bike has, but not really any of the other ones have everything that this bike has. So, you know, little details. I mean, it's got obviously the 114 motor, which you can get in some of the other Softails, but those bikes may or may not come with the inverted front end that this bike has. The inverted front end is obviously a really, really nice upgrade from the stock one. There are a few others that have the inverted front end. Take the Fat Bob, for example. The downside there is that the Fat Bob has the big fat front tire, whereas the Lowrider S has the more traditional narrow 19-inch rim in the front. So that to me is the perfect combination from the factory. Obviously, we're gonna go ahead and do a whole lot of work on this bike, so it's pretty perfect in terms of a factory bike, and we really, really love it, but there's obviously a ton more we can do to make this really a killer, killer bike. I've said before, Harley-Davidson, I think, builds motorcycles for the 80%. 80% of people are probably happy with 80% of the bike, and we consider ourselves to be in the 2% or maybe the 1% where we really, really want to upgrade and look at every component on the bike, not just to customize it for what we like, but also to run the very, very best components in every place that we can. So that's going to be the theme for this bike. We're not going to spare any expense. We're going to do everything that we think makes sense. We're not looking to just make an effort to spend as much money as possible. That's certainly not the case, but we're going to spend money in the right way, and we're going to put the right stuff on this bike. So we've got a lot of big plans. Obviously, the motor is part of it. Suspension is part of it. Controls and seating, hand controls, bars, foot pegs, all of that stuff is part of it. Like I mentioned, parts availability is a bit of a challenge, so we're waiting on some parts to get started with some of those bigger projects. So today's project is gonna be something a little bit smaller. But before we get to that, I do wanna talk a little bit about the 2021 model year and the motor. So if you've been paying attention at all or you've been shopping for a new bike, you'll know that Harley changed the ECU for the Model 21 bikes. So at the time that we're making this video and that we're doing this, we don't have the ability to tune this bike yet. We know that Dynajet is working on new software for the Power Vision to be able to get in and modify this ECU. So we're gonna wait patiently for them to do that. And in the meantime, we're gonna leave everything about the motor totally alone. There's really no reason to start messing around with motor work or even air cleaners and pipes before we're able to tune it. So The motor's probably gonna be towards the end of what we do, but that's okay because even right out of the box, a stock 114 is gonna get you where you wanna go. So we're gonna worry about kind of everything else and then we'll jump into the motor when we have the ability to do that. So enough delay on that. We'll talk a little bit about what today's project is gonna be. Like I said, real simple. So one of the first things that we notice about a stock bike is from Harley, you kind of have a lot of stuff going on back here that we're not totally fans of. And one of the easiest and quickest modifications that you can do to clean up the rear section of really any bike is to take a look at your turn signals, your taillight, and the license plate bracket. So we've got a real simple, real easy change for the bike for this particular one. And most of what we're doing is coming from Custom Dynamics. So it's gonna start with their integrated taillight, which is a layback LED smoked taillight that's got integrated turn signals in it. It's got an option for license plate light on the top, on the bottom, or none at all. We've got one on the top because that's where our license plate is. Also from Custom Dynamics, we've got a radius layback license plate bracket that we're gonna swap out this big kind of silly thing sticking out here. We are also at the same time going to replace the chrome taillight base with a black one that we also got from Custom Dynamics. And at the same time, and I'll show you in the wiring harness, it's not necessary to delete your turn signals when you do this, but we're gonna do it to clean up the bike. And what we're gonna do, obviously, if you take these turn signals off, you're left with some holes. So we've got some block off plates from Cycle Visions that we're gonna put in there in its place. So the last detail I wanna point out is there is one more piece that we need. If you've got any bike, Softail, Dyna, in that world, other than a Lowrider or a Lowrider S, this is a real simple, about 5 minute job. Pop all the stuff on, pop the new ones, and you're good to go. With the Lowrider and Lowrider S, you do need one additional piece, which is a wiring harness from Custom Dynamics. And I say need, this makes it a whole lot easier. You don't really need it. You could go in and wire it yourself. You could depin some harnesses and move some things around. But this harness makes it a lot easier. And what that it is that inside the taillight here, there's a circuit board that has a harness going into it that on most bikes has all your rear lighting. So your running light, your brake light, left turn signal, right turn signal. On the Lowriders, the turn signals are missing from that circuit board. The turn signal wires run separately through the fender struts directly to the turn signals on these bikes. So obviously we don't have the feed for the turn signals in the taillight where we need them. So Custom Dynamics has a solution for that like they do for almost everything else. One of the things that we love so much about Custom Dynamics, aside from the fact that their products are fantastic, is all the supplemental behind the scenes things that they offer. Wiring harnesses, adapters, controllers, all kinds of things, anything you need to make the product work, they've got it, which is really nice when you're trying to do something clean and plug and play. So what this harness is gonna do is gonna disconnect our rear turn signal wires from under the seat, and we're gonna plug this harness in and we're gonna run it under the fender to the taillight. And what's cool about this, let me open it up real quick, is that you obviously have the plugs that plug in where you're gonna disconnect the factory harness, and you also have the two new ends that are gonna run to the back here to hook up to your new taillight. But even beyond that, what's really nice is that on the bike side of it, you also have these additional pigtails that allow you to plug those stock connectors back in. So if you wanted to keep the functionality of your existing turn signals, this harness will do it, and it'll just give you two extra leads to run back to the taillight. So if you wanted to, let's say, either keep these lights the way they were and run the turn signals in the taillights, or swap these over to LEDs from Custom Dynamics or somebody else, you could do that. Or even change them entirely. Have your integrated taillight here, and then maybe grab a set of the fender tip turn signals from Alloy Art, which is a pretty cool addition that we might add on later down the road. So we're gonna leave all the stock wiring in place in case we do ever wanna go back and add a turn signal in this location. So really great little product. It's not expensive as an add-on, couple of bucks extra when you're getting all the other stuff. So With all that said, we're gonna reposition a little bit, we're gonna dig in, and we're gonna start doing this. The only other call out, like I said, right in the beginning of the video, this isn't gonna be a real step-by-step exact how-to on how to do all this. We're gonna go fairly quickly and just show you what you're doing so you can kind of see the progress. This is all pretty easy stuff. If you've got any questions, of course, feel free to leave a comment below and we'll try to get back to you, or shoot us a message or an email, and we'd be more than happy to answer any questions. And in addition, of course, if there's anything a little bit weird or complicated, we'll make an effort to call that out just so that we can be as helpful as possible. So that said, let's dig into it and let's clean up this rear tail section. All right, so we're ready to go. And the first thing we're gonna do is just start taking some stock stuff off to get access to all the places we need to get to start installing our new parts. All right, so back here, like I was talking about, this is the circuit board, and this is where you would typically see, if you had a different model bike, you'd see your right and left turn signals connected here. These plugs are pinned, so it looks like that they're live, but they're not. There's not, the signal isn't being fed to this circuit board. And a pretty easy way to tell that is you got a couple wires missing from the harness that's coming from the front of the bike. So if you're not sure, just pop your taillight off and look, and if your turn signals are connected here, you're good to go. If they're not, you're gonna need to run that feed up from the front of the bike. So that's what we're gonna do. And what you want to do as you're doing this is make an effort to hold it as still as possible before you pull it off. Because as you can see, Harley does not put any kind of grommet or washer or anything back here. So if this thing moves all around, it's going to scratch your paint. The new one we put on has got a nice rubber piece that goes underneath to protect the fender. All right, so looking at our Custom Dynamics integrated taillight, a couple pieces in the box here. You got some instructions. You've got a cleaning wipe. You've got a gasket that's made of foam. And then you've got your taillight with the wiring harness. Now, this is what I was talking about in terms of the turn signals and the brake light. This part of the harness is gonna be your running light and brake light. And then these two others are gonna be for your left and right turn signals. Now, again, if you've got a bike other than a lowrider, these are just gonna plug right into that circuit board and you'll be good to go. We're gonna run that harness up so that these have something to plug into. Additionally, and this is another reason Custom Dynamics is so great, you also get an additional set of extra pigtails here, where if you didn't have a low rider, just like on that harness where there was those extra pigtails to plug the OE harness back in, if you have a harness that connects here from the factory, you can plug your turn signals right back in here so you don't lose anything. In our case, these are just gonna be extra, so we'll just tuck them in there, but really, really nice that they always do all this stuff on all their parts. So there's the inside of the fender strut. You can see that turn signal wire running through there. And we're gonna undo this screw to get this turn signal out. And I think what we're gonna do now is actually, we will go ahead and, well, I'm not sure if we wanna pull the wiring out of here or not yet. Let's take a look at that and see what we got. All right, so there's that fender. So the way these are wired, obviously, you've got a plug on the one side, not on the light side. So it doesn't really do us a whole lot of good to leave the wiring in here if we've got to cut it. So what I think we're gonna do, just for a little bit of doing something different, is I think for the moment we're gonna pull these wires out, but I think we might go back and reuse these if we decide to put some fender tip turn signals on here, which the more I think about it, the more I kind of want to do. So right now we'll just put these back on, minus the wiring, and we'll go from there. Cool. So before we put this back on, we're going to take our block off plate and install that in here. I'm just going to walk over to the workbench and do that, and probably do the other side as well. And we'll just come back and we'll see where we're at. All right, so fender struts are back on. We did the other side too. As you can see, we got the little block off plate from Cycle Visions in here. If you saw in the packet, let me grab them. The Cycle Visions kit came with black screws for here, which are these. And I don't know if you can tell by looking at it here, but that's obviously way too long. So we just went into the parts bin, found some stainless steel 5/16 button head screws that were a lot shorter, I think probably about 3/4 inch. And we put those in there. I think this is fine. You know, it definitely cleans the area here up a little bit. But that said, I'm really starting to think more and more now about doing the fender strut lights from Alloy Art. So we might come back for another video on the tail section here and do that. We'll sit with the bike a little bit and see how it looks once it's all together. But in the meantime, we're gonna keep going and we'll start to get this integrated taillight installed. All right, well, that's gonna delay us a little bit here. So it looks like the base plate that we got here doesn't actually fit. I'll take it off and show you why. So our OE plate is notched here for this bracket, and the replacement one is not. So to be fair, just pulled this off the shelf and didn't totally check to see if it had a specific fitment or not. Kind of figured they were all the same. But we'll go take a look in the custom dynamics book and see what we can find. All right, so instead of waiting for the to replace this with the black one that's got the indent, we decided just to keep going so we could get this all put back together, at least just finish this up for today. We'll come back and probably swap this for a black one down the road. So anyway, taillight back on, or base plate back on. We'll go ahead and put the light on. Now it's just a matter of plugging in all the connectors here. All right, so the challenge here is you got all these extra wiring connectors. They really don't want to fit inside this taillight. So I'm sure there's a way to do it. So we're just going to try and keep rearranging until we can find a spot where everything will clear. So there's that. Like I said, we're gonna keep this taillight, but we'll eventually change this base plate out for a black one. And then we just gotta make our connections up here at the front for the turn signals. So before we button this up, just grab the key, make sure this is all working as it should. All right, so there's our taillight. Brake. Brake. Turn to the right. And looks like we got it backwards. All right, no problem. Just flip these around. But it's always a good idea to double check before close everything up. Let's try that again. All right, right. There we go. And left. Cool. All right. So now we're gonna just tidy this area up a little bit. So go ahead and put our license plate bracket on. All right, so this may seem like kind of a silly thing, but there's actually so much that's better about this than the stock one. Obviously, once it's on here, it just looks so much cleaner. It's radiused, it's laid back, it's all great. It's one piece instead of that kind of two-part bracket. The other one, you can't really access the tops of the fasteners. This one, obviously, they just go right in. It's just a really nice, it's a silly thing, but it's really nice. So we're gonna go ahead and get this installed. I'm just gonna pull this little sticker I just noticed off the back here. Not sure if that would have been visible, but better to have it off. So, last piece that's obviously nice, the little rubber grommet that goes in here. And they do give you a little cutout in the middle here in case you do decide that you want to run a license plate light on your light. You've got a hole in here. You're just going to have to drill a matching hole in your fender. In our case, we're not doing that because we've got the license plate light in here. So we just cut the wires off of our license plate frame. We're going to put it on. All right, so you can run these with your plate just right on there. You don't need a frame. This plate's obviously got a little notch in the top of it from the bike that it used to be on. We needed to do that for the frame. So I do want to put a frame on here to cover that up. What we've got is a frame from Custom Dynamics. This one has little LED lights in it. It's got a wire that used to come out of here. So we do with these a lot of times is just cut the wire off if we don't want to use it. So it's perfectly easy to do if you want to. You just drill a hole in here and then you come into here and pick up a running light circuit and just tap that in. It does involve, like I said, a little bit of finagling. You got to get you have to notch your plate up in this corner and you have to run the wire behind the plate and down to this hole. It's not a big deal. We just don't need it in this case, so we're gonna just take it off. And I suppose you could go get a bracket that didn't already come with the lights, but this isn't that expensive. And in my experience, finding a radius plate frame that's not shitty and that fits nicely on these is pretty hard to do. So these are a pretty easy way to do it. The holes all line up, everything works, it's radiused exactly the same. So it's just an easy way to make that happen. So, tell me that's not better than that big stupid thing sticking up with the reflective plastic screws that they give you from the dealership. So, I think, looking around, I don't see any more parts here, so I think that's gonna be it. Let's reposition, got a better look. All right, so that's gonna do it on this little project to clean up the tail section of our 2021 Lowrider S. Just to recap what we did, we deleted our OE turn signals and replaced them with some covers from Cycle Visions. We've got an integrated tail light with turn signals built in from Custom Dynamics, and we've also got from Custom Dynamics a plate, bracket, and frame that's radiused and laid back. So we definitely, I think, did a good job of starting to change the look of this bike a little bit. We've got our turn signals functional on both sides, and you know, that'll do the job for now. And we'll see where we wind up. Still got the right wires connected. Our next step is gonna be really based on, like I said, how parts come in, and we'll see what starts to take place. But in the meantime, there are a couple things that don't involve any parts that we're gonna wanna do on this. So we might jump back with a quick video either later today, we might work on it, or come back in a couple of days. We'll see how things go. But in the meantime, make sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel if you wanna keep up with all the videos that we do in this build series, as well as some others that we've got planned. Like I said, this is gonna be a pretty exciting project. We started with some small little details here, but hopefully these are some helpful things, because I think a lot of people like to do these sorts of little projects on their bike in addition to some of the big ones we tackle. So we're trying to show a little bit of everything, and hopefully find something that you like or you wanna try and tackle yourself. If you need any help, make sure to give us a call, and we'll help you out. Until then, take it easy.